In this illustration, we'll study about age determination by radioactive series. Here we are given that in nature, a decay chain series starts with the thorium and finally terminates at lead. And we are given that a thorium sample was found to contain 8×10⁻⁵ ml of helium at STP and 5×10⁻⁷ gram of thorium. We are required to find the age of sample, assuming the source of helium to be only the decay of thorium. Here we can consider that helium is produced by emission of alpha particles, and also assume complete retention of helium within the ore sample, and half-life is also given to us. So here in solution, first if we analyze the reaction, so here we can say a radioactive series is, here it is given that thorium 232 decays to lead, which is 208. And if we talk about the mass number difference of a starting element and the end product, here we can see this 232 - 208, which is 24. And this difference is certainly only due to emission of alpha particles. So if we calculate the number of alpha particles, emitted by each thorium, then this can be written as 24/4, because one alpha causes a difference in mass number by 4. So this will be 6 alpha particles per decay, or corresponding to each thorium nuclei, 6 alpha particles are emitted. And if we calculate the number of helium atoms in sample, here you can see number of atoms are equal to the number of total alpha particles emitted. So this can be written as NH or N alpha, and this must be written as PV by KT. We are using gas law, and for a standard temperature and pressure, we can take P as 1.013 × 10⁵, 1 atmospheric pressure. Volume we are given with the 8×10⁻⁵ ml. So we multiply it with 10⁻⁶ for to be in meter cube, divided by 1.38×10⁻²³. The Boltzmann constant and temperature is 273 Kelvin. On simplifying this expression, you'll get 2.151×10⁵15 atoms, or this much number of total alpha particles are emitted here. So if we calculate number of thorium decay, 232 decay in total, or if we calculate it, this must be N alpha divided by 6, because each thorium decay produces 6 alpha particles in the radioactive series. So here we divide it by 6, this gives us 0.3585×10⁵15 decays. This much number of thorium decay have been occurred within this duration. And if we calculate total number of thorium nuclei in sample, then we can calculate it as N0. We are given the mass 5×10⁻⁷ gram of thorium. So this will be 5×10⁻⁷ multiplied by Avogadro number, divided by its mass number, that is 232, which is coming out to be 1.298 into 10 to power 15 nuclei. And out of these much number of nuclei, the total number which are decayed till now are given as this, which we have calculated by using the amount of helium present in the sample. So we can write number of thorium-232 left at present are, we can write n is equals to n0 minus this value, which is n alpha by 6. So we subtract these two values, this gives us 0.9395 into 10 to power 15 nuclei. Now we can use by radioactive decay law. Here we can write n is equals to n0 to the power minus t by t. Now in this situation, simplifying this gives us the calculation of time, which is minus t log of 7.2 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 1 divided by this numerical value we are substituting here, divided by log 2, which is 0.301. So in this situation, when we simplify this value, you can see I've already substituted the value of n and n0 over here. So on simplifying this result, I'm getting, on substituting the value of half lifetime, which is given as 1.39 into 10 to the power 10 multiplied by the 0.142 divided by 0.301. Finally, we are getting 6.59 into 10 to the power 9 years. That is the result of this problem, the age of the thorium sample.